Hello YouTubers, this is JC NBA A350 fan with another review of Gemini 200 Lufthansa Cargo Boeing 777-200F with a registration D-Alpha and a Good Day USA. With a brief history, Lufthansa operated a cargo subsidiary called German Cargo between 1977 and 1993. Earlier steel cargo operators were executed in-house under the Lufthansa Cargo name. When in an effort to restructure the company, the cargo division was reintegrated to its parent and split up into two parts. One for scheduled operations using Lufthansa-owned aircraft, and one for freight and logistics services using chartered or leased aircraft. So, Lufthansa Cargo was created as a limited stock company on November 30, 2004, along with Lufthansa Cargo Charter. Lufthansa Cargo uses LH, the same IATA code as Lufthansa, as well as GEC, the former ICAO code of German Cargo, as airline codes. Lufthansa is unique compared to its major European competitors like British Airways and Air France in that the cargo business is organized in an entirely different airline entity. For some years, Lufthansa Cargo, including the freighted transported in the cargo holds of mainline Lufthansa passenger aircraft, was the leading cargo airline in terms of international freight ton kilometers carried, but has since been surpassed by Cathay Pacific and Korean Air Cargo. As of 2011, all Lufthansa cargo aircraft are based at Frankfurt Airport, the 7th busiest freight hub in the world, where the airline enjoys a strong cooperation with Fraport, the operator of the airport. Cargo facilities at the airport are divided into two places, Cargo City, North and South, of which the first one is nearly exclusively used by Lufthansa Cargo. In 2000, Lufthansa Cargo was a founding member of WOW Alliance and a Global Cargo Airline Alliance, but left in 2007 as it did not see any benefits for the future. So in May 2011, Lufthansa Cargo opened another hub at Rajiv Gandhi International Airport in Hyderabad in order to transport temperature-sensitive goods, especially pharmaceuticals, between Southeast Asia and Europe and onwards to the United States. Alright, moving on. This is the box. And then it opens up with the Velcro. Inside, if you want to read it, pause for a while and you can read. I don't know if it's clear, but there you go. Lufthansa Cargo, 777-200F, D-Alpha, Good Day USA. Right. So. This side is the same. We got the item number G2D LH486 Gemini 200. As real as it gets. Lufthansa. And that's it. Here is the model, the 777-200F Lufthansa Cargo with registration DALFA Good Day USA. Let's go ahead and look at the nose of the aircraft. It You got the nose cone? You got the partial registration? And nose gear door. There's the title of Lufthansa Cargo. They only have one door, I guess L1 door for all the passengers and pilots. And then we got the Lufthansa logo and let's see if you can read the name. Boeing 777 freighter. Good day, USA, if you can read. And then we got one of two GE90-110 engine. Beautiful big engines. The size of a 737 fuselage. That big. Got the wing, left wing. There you go. We have a, the main, it's not that clear, but it's the main cargo door. Underneath is the registration, the alpha, and the German flag, I guess, and then the Lufthansa logo. I guess this is a better logo than the new one, as they changed the livery, but this is an old one, but I think it's better. First partial registration FA. And horizontal stabilizers. All right, let's move it around. We got the APU exhaust, our auxiliary power unit. Nicely done. We have the other horizontal stabilizers. A view from the back. Moving on. Starboard side. Or the right side. Right, still we got the Lufthansa cargo title. Hopefully we can capture them. Small names, whatever that is. Whatever you call it. And then we have the R1 door. A number two engine, GE90-110. And then we got the air registration. engines do spin. Spins. Next one, let's see. The spin. Oops. Alright, moving on. Upper, top. Beacon light. Lufthansa cargo title. Left and right. Antenna. ADF antenna. One of the 2G beautiful engines. Slats, flaps, ailerons, pylons. Air fuel duct belt. Right side. GE9110. I guess no registration. Alright. You got the SATCOM antenna, vertical, horizontal, and the two, I mean, the vertical stabilizer and the two horizontal stabilizers. A beautiful Lufthansa logo. Underneath, nose gear. Gemini logo, holes for stand, to the bogie gears, bogies, whatever you call it, the pylons, the two beautiful GE engines, GE antenna, GPU housing, pressure relief valve, and I think the air conducts. And that's it. Alright, here is the stand that came with it, as usual. It's in wood. Gemini logo, Gemini jets. I took out the stickers already. And then, still there's no plaque or name. A company name. It's, I mean, Gemini Jet should have just wrote down the name rather than on the bottom, and it should be on the top rather than the bottom. Anyway, that's it, guys. Let's put it on the stand. Tilting front gear 2 magnetic, you can take it out and replace with a cover. That's it for my review. Comment, subscribe, please do like if you like it. I really need some subscribers for now. For more videos, please. And thank you for watching. Alright, signing off for now. See you for more videos, for more video uploads. And have fun watching it. Thank you.